This man, he used to be from Fatah movement. And he has three sons. One of them condemned also as a man from Fatah movement, as between the quotation, he's activist, but between the quotation as a terrorist. Okay. He condemned as a terrorist and he must stay in the jail 10,000 years. Can you imagine it? And the other son of him, he condemned also the same, and he must stay in the jail 40 years. The last one, 14 years. He never been with his sons. Nowadays, it's not allowed to him to visit his sons in the jail. And he also condemned as a terrorist. It's not allowed to him to go over Hebron, just only to stay in Hebron. They used to own these shops and it was full of goods. Now, as you see, just only he sells some things in order to feed his house and to cover his expenses. And he didn't manage it. This is the Palestinian stories. You see now, this is the Shuhada street again here. And you can see the closer also, the wall here, they put a wall. All of these houses confiscated from the soldiers and the settlers. And the soldiers over us, as you see them, and this is that flag is the flag of the soldiers and the Israeli flag.
You know which troop? Which troop is this?
They are from Givati. You see? And you can see the checkpoint also in the beginning of the cemetery. The cemetery behind us is systemic cemetery. It's not allowed to us to bury our beloved when they passed away. And now you can look here. This is Abraham Avenue. This is the market, it's the main vegetable market in Hebron. It's confiscated now and it's become as a settlement. They destroyed, they demolished all of the Palestinians' houses from here. Some of them are still the old buildings, as you see, construct a new building on it. And it's confiscated from them. Even the shops down, you can see it. It's also closed and confiscated from those settlers. You can see the checkpoint also behind them on the roof of Palestinian house. You see how they are close to them, really. You see that place which we were in it. You see? That place when the man shouted to us. That place, you see? All of the old city, just only from the center, from here through Shuhada Street, just only 5 minutes walking. Now we walk several hours. The people here, several hours walking around through the cemetery there to go Shuhada Street until they arrive at the center of the city. You can see now, this is Shuhada Street, which leads also near my house there. At the top of the hill, you see the colony, and between there, my house, the street completely closed, which we saw it also from Cordoba, which I said to you that it's closed completely. It leads to the Abraham Mosque. That's the street. And it leads there. This is the Abraham Mosque. It leads to it. Just only 5 minutes from the center of the city. If a Shuhada street opened, we will be here near the Abraham Mosque. And this is a checkpoint, as you see, it's divided the city. The other side, as you see, they cannot come from here, just only they can park their cars here and pass this checkpoint if they want to go to the old city. Now you can see this is the Abraham Mosque, and the Abraham Mosque is divided to two sides, one side for the Palestinians, for the Muslims, and the other for the Jews. This place, you see, it belongs to the Jews. As you see, the Jews, they are coming here. Yaakov, the son of Abraham, his wife, Laika, and Joseph, who are buried in this place. And they pretended that it's a holy place for them, so they divided it completely. And this is in the year 1994. After a massacre of Dr. Goldstein, he is Baruch Goldstein. He is an Israeli doctor, phonetic doctor. He, with coordination of the soldiers, they opened one of the gates, we will see it inside for him. And during Ramadan, during the morning pray, He came and with automatic guns, he shot Palestinians inside, 37 of them killed and 80 injured. The checkpoints, you can see now the checkpoints, we have to pass this one checkpoint and after that another two checkpoints inside. Instead of the checkpoints in the entrance there, we will see it after we go out from the mosque. And really, as you see, the checkpoints only for the Palestinians. The other side, for the Jews, there is no checkpoints. They can go free, they can run everything free. And the garden also of the Abraham Mosque is confiscated for them. It's not allowed to the Palestinians to be there. Really, it's called Jawliya. The name took from persons who construct this place. It's called, he's from Jawa. He came from Jawa, from Malaysia. That's why they called it Jawliya. This is more than 1,000 years ago.